Wendell, pack. The extra rations. Duff, make sure the quivers are full and the torches are dry. Garrett.
What's happening?
We're heading north of the wall to deliver justice to brothers turned traitor. They're hiding in the woods at a place called Craster's Keep. I've been looking for volunteers.
The cowards murdered Commander Mormon.
How far north is this Craster's?
Some 60 miles into Wildling territory. It's treacherous country. I appreciate if you're thinking of going, but you should know Britt volunteered.
He took his vows in the sect. He's a brother now.
I understand why you hate him. But bad blood could jeopardize this mission. Too many unknowns out there. I can't have my own men killing each other.
I'm a ranger now. I've left my past behind me. Britt included.
Until you're standing next to him with a sword in your hand. That's the real test. If you do come, I need to know there won't be any trouble. Even if he provokes you.
And no more talk of the North Grove either.
Can I count on you? I need your word, Garrett. I'll be taking a chance.
I understand. You won't have any trouble from me.
I'll hold you to that. It's a hard road to Craster's. We leave tomorrow at first light.
Now why don't you go talk to those two? They volunteered as well, make sure they're ready. Duff! Where are my arrows?
Well, what did Jon Snow say? I don't think he likes us much.
Definitely doesn't like you, Finn.
Haven't heard him singing your praises, any.
He wants to see us work together. No more problems.
That's on you.
Point is, he doesn't want any problems with either of you on this Craster's mission.
Well, there's something you should know, then. I borrowed this from you.
What?
I just got curious. I wanted to know why your uncle was here.
It never ends with you.
I didn't mean no harm, honest. I just wanted a quick look. I wasn't stealing.
You can't keep doing that, Cotter. Next time, ask.
I did try. And you said he was just visiting.
But I think there's more to it than that, isn't there?
I noticed this part here.
North Grove. That's just some shit story for little kids. A rumor.
No, it's not.
Of course it is. I heard it's a witch's den where they turn children into giants. Garrett, you don't actually take it seriously, do you? It's a fairy tale. For idiots. Everyone knows that.
Lord Forrester knew all about it. He said it's a place of great power. Power that could save my house.
And this says it's somewhere in the north. On the other side of the wall.
And here I thought you might have some brains, Garrett. You two deserve each other. Have fun chasing your tails.
Good. Didn't need him anyway.
What do you mean?
Finn doesn't know about the mammoths or white walkers or how to sneak past a giant.
What, and you do?
But you know, it's the things you hear about. The rumours is all. I wouldn't know myself.
Rumours my arse. You're hiding something, Cotter.
I'm not. They're just things I hear around Castle Blacksall. People talk, you know.
Not about the North Grove. They don't.
You do? Probably heard you talking about it. Or maybe one of the recruits.
Don't make me regret lying about the knife for you, Cotter. Tell me what you know.
All right.
Oh,
I've been on the other side of the wall, Garrett. See, I live there. In the north. I'm part of the free folk. People round here call wildlings. I know, it's crazy.
I was with some other free folk. We were looking for weapons, south of the wall. We got caught, so I passed myself off as a local and, well, they sentenced me here to Castle Black for stealing.
I shouldn't be here. This isn't my place. I didn't know what else to do.
You're quiet. I hope that means you'll keep this quiet.
Are we... we still friends?
I mean... I know it's a lot to take in.
Don't worry. Bloodthirsty wildling or not, we're still brothers.
That is good to hear. At least when Mance Raider wants to boil you alive, you'll know someone in high places.
Cutter! What did I say? That shithouse you fixed is still leaking!
Be right there!
I'm going back home, no matter what, Garrett. I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about.
You know where the North Grove is?
No. But I'll help you find it. I'm deserting anyway, heading back home. I can guide you, keep you alive.
Stick with me and I'll show you the way.
All right. Even if you are a bloodthirsty wildling.
I won't let you down.
Cutter! Now!
On the way!
Please, don't tell anyone about me. The Watch would kill me if they found out.
Marine still smells like shit, even outside the walls.
We'll find Croft here, somewhere. You alright?
Never better. Back under the Mad King, they used to say death by sword was a sweet kiss. But fire would fuck you hard.
Funny.
No, not very.
I'll go find Croft's tent.
Asher, I need you to tell me the truth. I've come a long way to bring you home. Back in that cave, you made a choice. You must have thought only one of us was going to survive. Now, it's not a fair question to ask, but I need to know.
I fought beside you, Uncle, too many times to count. I figured you could handle yourself. Beska was the one face to face with a dragon.
I appreciate the respect, but it's not about that. Look, I can't blame you if your feelings about me are conflicted. Or your feelings about going home. Your family exiled you to this place. But I swore an oath to your mother, sailed halfway around the world to bring you back safe. And I'll be damned if some dragonfire or your foul decisions are gonna stop me. Are we clear? I'm here to help you.
Well, come on, Malcolm. Why are you making this such a big thing?
We're defined by the choices we make, Asher. One day, you'll understand that.
Asher, I know where Croft is.
This Croft, how well do you know him?
Too well.
I thought you said you were friends.
Yeah, we are. We are. Great friends.
Asher fucking Forrester! Son of a poxy whore! You have some balls walking into my tent after all these years with that mama's monkey grin on your face.
Well, that went well. Great friends indeed.
Oh, that's it. You're losing your edge, Croft.
You know you're right. I should kill you. Good fucking advice.
Whoa! No, I wasn't actually suggesting.
You never understood consequences, Asher. One stupid mistake cost me an eye. But you never learn. You figured you'd steal from me and I'd just forgive you? Not a fucking chance. So how are you going to pay me back? Your eye? Your hand? Or how about your tongue?
Croft, no!
Be reasonable. I am reasonable! I'm letting him fucking choose.
My hair could use a trim. Take some off the top, would you?
Do not fucking test me!
Croft, I deserve your anger as much as Asha.
Don't worry, Beshka. You're next. Now choose, or I slice off your balls, Asha.
A man
betrays my trust. There's a price to be paid.
Let him go!
Fuck you, Croft!
Have it your way. You didn't need your testicles anyway.
Oh, that was bloody beautiful. Fucking Asher. You were pale as a snow bear's ass.
Are you fucking joking?
You bloody bastard.
This is why people steal your shit and take off in the night.
Come on, you assholes. Have a drink.
Jodan, the Khaleesi's best wine.
Your friend has an interesting sense of humor.
So what in seven hells are you two doing here on the arse end of the earth, eh? You're a long way from young guy.
We have a proposition for you.
We need an army, Croft. My home back in Westeros is under siege.
We need your hellhounds. 100 good men.
Am I in a hobby's tin? Would I ever go back to Westeros?
I've got it good right here. Her Grace pays good coin.
We can pay.
I always knew your pockets were lined with gold. And I will happily take it from you. But it's not up to me. The Second Sons are sworn to Daenerys Targaryen. I've laid my sword at her feet. For now.
Perhaps we could talk to her.
She's a little busy right now, commanding a fucking siege. Her enemies are nailing children up on post for 100 miles. And a bloody dragon's gone missing.
But I know where to find her dragon.
Unfucking likely. You expect me to believe you've just happened to have seen the one fucking dragon loose in the world?
Black scales all over with a red frill running down his back.
That doesn't prove anything. Enough of this nonsense. We're done here, Asher.
I've got proof, you old fuck. Tell me what this is, if not a bloody dragon tooth.
I wouldn't know a dragon tooth from a basilisk dick.
Croft. I've seen her dragon.
Oh, bugger me with a bloody spear. If you're lying about this, it'll cost more than your balls.
Fair enough.
Come on, you son of a bitch. The beast's name is Drogon. You'll want to hear about him right away. And don't think you're going to charm her with that fucking Asher grin.
Big day tomorrow, isn't it? Off to Craster's Keep.
Assuming you're not too busy looking for your North Grove.
I thought you didn't believe in it.
Not saying I do.
But if it was real, can you trust Potter with it?
You ask me. There's just something off about him. Aside from him being an oily thief, I mean.
Potter's not a bad sort. I trust him.
Even after he tried stealing your map? Do as you like. But if we're going out there tomorrow, in the middle of fucking nowhere, I'd want to know who I can trust.
Finn, get back on watch until your relief arrives.
They're late.
You think Mance Rayder is going to wait for them?
Right.
Asshole.
And Tuttle, you've got torches that have gone out. Keep them lit. Let the wildlings know we're still home.
Yeah, this one's still good. That's ironwood for sure. If anyone tries coming over the wall, well, those will stop them.
Pig farmer. A 300-mile walk, and you're still in my way.
I figured we'd settle things on the way to Craster's, but this is even better.
The wall's a dangerous place. People slip off all the time.
Still have some fighting spirit left in you, huh?
I did duty to my lord back on that bloody farm. And for doing a proper job of it, what I get? Banished to the fucking wall!
I never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig. Seemed only fair he should feel what it's like. Near the end, he could barely breathe. Kept begging us to leave your sister alone. So I made sure he was still alive when she started screaming. It was the last thing your father ever heard. The more we sliced, the worse it got.
Shrieking the whole time. Her crying out.
You fucking shit!
Temper, temper. Too bad your father didn't fight like that. Might still be alive. And I thought you were going to make this easy. Finally getting the hang of it, Tuttle.
Stop, damn it! I don't want to fight you!
What's the matter? Don't you want to make your father proud? Let's see if you scream like your sister.
Lucky, pig farmer. You didn't kill my man back at your farm. At least let me have my sword. Keep it interesting.
I swore my vows. I won't kill a brother.
You're fucking pathetic, Tuttle.
Ah!
Нихуя. Блять, я его пощадить хотел, ебал его. Сука. Пошел нахуй, сейчас сожжу нахуй. Так, что с рукой? Так пойдет.
Let's fucking finish it. Go on.
We're done here.
Finn!
Блять, хотел пощадить, в итоге все равно он там, блять, нахуй помер. Что за хуйня? Пиздец. Ну, поебашь этого сразу, нахуй.
My lord, our people are starving and afraid. The White Hills have driven them away from the Ironwood Groves. Out of the way! And so they come to us, looking for food. Food we don't have to spare. How can we support an army and retain our position in the north? We can't even feed the people we see before us. It's like the dead of winter's come. And it doesn't look like it's getting better.
These are hard times, to be sure. Harder than I've ever seen. But I'll do whatever it takes to get us through it.
Well, I hope we can figure something out. As long as the White Hills are in our house, we have to be careful. Come on, you!
Let me go! You can't do this!
Good. You're here. Look. Look at this! Did you see what this girl did? She attacked my man like an animal.
Bloody bit me.
Yeah, now it's her turn. She's gonna get what she has coming to her. This won't go unpunished.
Let go of me.
I don't care if she's your sister.
She bit your man. How did that happen? What did he do to her?
That doesn't matter. It matters what she did.
I saw him stealing from our kitchen, and I told him to stop. He laid his hands on me, so I bit him.
Bloody wench!
I was only doing what had to be done.
I warned you not to mistreat my men. Someone will have to answer for this. Do you hear me? Don't make this ugly.
We've done enough for you. You can't push us any further.
I can push you as much as I like. And if your people don't see that, they need to learn their place. This girl is out of control.
Don't listen to him, Roderick.
And if you can't rein her in, yeah, what about the rest of them? It's about time she saw a real lord again and learned proper discipline.
Are you afraid of a young girl with all the armed soldiers you
what?
Have?
I'm not afraid! I want order! But this house is in a shambles. And the problem starts at the top, Roderick.
Careful, boy.
You yourself had the gall to make threats against my men. And that's the real problem with you foresters. You're too fucking proud. Always have been. It was bad enough when you were above us. And now it's even worse. Because you don't see how far you've fallen.
Still high enough.
Forgive her. The passions of youth. Tigriff, you have the power.
Oh, I like him. You thought this was your man, Roderick? He's mine. A dog to be sure, but my dog. That's how I like to see you, foresters. Obedient servants!
He's a loyal member of my house. A man of peace. And he deserves to be treated as such.
You don't get it, do you? You foresters need to learn when you're beaten. You will learn some fucking humility.
Or this won't be the last lesson I teach you, foresters!
Have you no honor? I'll run you through for that! I'll cut you down like straw men!
I'm fine, Roland! I'm fine! I'll handle this!
Even broken, he's twice the man you are.
I bet this makes you angry, eh? You probably want to get up and hit me. But we know how that would go, don't we? Now, are you going to be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down?
Roderick!
I said, get down! All the way down.
Get up, Roderick!
Stay down, my lord.
Your brother defied Ramsay Snow. He didn't know his place, but we made damn sure he learned. I'll probably have to teach Talia. Unless you're a good little forester, you learn your place and stay down. Some forester is gonna learn their lesson today.
You don't have to do that, Lord Griff.
I'll stay down.
Consider this even, girl. Your brother learned the lesson for you. You'd be wise to follow his lead. As would all of you. Your lord is a smart man. First in his line that understands. Now you need to understand too. You can be Lord Roderick, so long as we all know who holds the reins here. Come on.
You did the right thing, my son. You had to submit.
Aye. A true lord.
But we let them win. Do you see that? He still acts like he rules the house. But he's let his guard down. So, did he get what he wanted? Or did you? At the time, I wanted you to crush him.
He thinks he's won. That he and his men have gone soft now. They won't be ready when we do strike back.
And when you're better, things will be different. I asked Ethan not to change who he was. I tried to make him promise me. I now know that was childish of me. I'm ready to change now. I'm willing to do anything to help our family. I mean it, Roderick. I don't care what.
That's good. I'm sure a time will come when our house will call upon you to do what's necessary. But that time is not now.
And I'm sure the others will do whatever it takes as well. What you did, yielding to Griff, you had your reasons. But
no one can know the future. Whatever tomorrow brings, Talia, the foresters will stand tall.
We did it. I can't believe it. What are you waiting for?
There's no good that can come from this. Not anymore.
The Khaleesi will see you now.
So, Asher Forrester,
If you presume to speak of my dragons, choose your words carefully.
What have you done, Garrett? Frostfinger is calling for your head. Tell me Britt's death was an accident.
Mira, what are you doing?
Mira, just tell me what's going on. What are you hiding from me?
We are weak.
We have no allies. And Griff claims to be the new lord of Ironwrath.
There's been a raven from Lord Whitehill. He's invited us to Highpoint.
Drogon wouldn't have attacked without reason.
By order of the Queen!
Fuck you and your Queen.
Deal with your friend.
Nothing ever stays in the past, Asher.
Garrett. It's time to go.
Previously on Game of Thrones.
Ладно, чего ж, выбор есть выбор. Thank you.
Previously on Game of Thrones.
My father is planning to make a move against your family. He knows all your weaknesses, all your plans, because you have a traitor in your council. He's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing.
We were told we'd be speaking to Lord Tyrion alone.
That's enough, Andros.
Northgrove? That's just some shit story for little kids.
I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about. I'm part of the Free Folk. People round here call wildlings.
My true name is Sarah Flowers.
You're a bastard?
I hope I didn't make a mistake in trusting you.
And if it isn't Elena Glenmore? You're not still marrying into this wretched family.
Perhaps we'll remain allies after all.
It's a long journey to Meereen on foot.
Meereen? Shit.
What?
Unfinished business there. I don't want to talk about it.
If you presume to speak of my dragons, you best choose your words carefully.
Malcolm! Are you gonna be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down? You can be Lord Roderick, so long as we all know who holds the reins here.
The foresters need to keep their end of the bargain. Take the boy as your ward. Kill him if they give you any trouble.
I never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig.
I knew you were a killer the day you arrived. Seems Britt found out too. Now they all see it.
It wasn't my fault. He attacked me and we fought and...
So you struck him down and left him to die. You told me what you did to get here. We both know you had blood on your hands. But now you've killed one of your brothers. You'll lose your head for this, Tuttle. You'll be disgraced, dishonored, and burned till there's nothing left of you.
You won't execute me. With Mance Raider coming, the Night's Watch needs all the men it can get.
Honest men. Loyal men. Not brother killers. There's only one thing to be done with you now.
Hey, Frostfinger. I saw what Garrett did to Britt last night. I was there. My relief was late, so I stayed behind.
Yeah, he was there.
Then go on. What did you see, boy?
Garrett's telling the truth. Britt attacked him. Just like he said, Garrett had no choice but to fight back.
There isn't a man at the wall wouldn't sell his own mother for the right price. You two are up to something. Some deal you worked out. Or he's defending you for...
No, we're not. He's telling the truth. You can't fault a man for defending himself.
Garrett killed a man of the Watch. There's a price to be paid for that. Let's go. I knew it was a mistake to make you a ranger.
Rosfinger! What's to be done with him? We're heading to Crusted.
You'll have to find someone else for your expedition. Your man here still has a lot to answer for. Now out of the way, Snow.
Give us a moment.
Then kiss him quick and be done with it.
Garrett. You told me there wouldn't be any trouble with Brit.
What happened?
I thought you were smarter than that, Garrett.
I thought you were going to be by my side at Crestus.
This isn't right. Brit's the murderer. Frostfinger has this all wrong.
What Brit did to your family. Anyone would want him dead.
But John...
Is there nothing to be done?
Aside from removing Tuttle's head from his shoulders? No.
But...
You're about to go off and execute a nest full of traitors at Crestus. How is this any different?
Gods be with you, Garrett. We're down a man, so keep your eyes open. Now let's move.
You can go begging to your gods all you want, boy. It's the axe has the final say.
Do you know how many men have stood before me with false tales of my dragons? Desperate men, hoping for wealth, protection. Liars, every one of them. And I expect you are no different. You don't want to see what I do to liars.
Then maybe you should get to know me better. I'm not like those other men.
You sure look like the rest of them. Covered in dirt.
Oh, shit.
Are you frightened? I thought you'd seen a dragon before. Your reaction says otherwise. Viseron, it's all right.
He's much smaller than the other one.
Would you like to touch him? Go ahead. Unless you are afraid. Of course, a man who has really faced a dragon before may have reason to be afraid. Go on.
Not a good idea, Asher.
Thank you. You're brave, at least.
I don't think he likes me.
You still have a hand, don't you? You claim you saw Drogon. Give me a reason to believe you. I told you I've heard this story before. I'm going to need more than that.
You're asking for proof?
My friend has the burns to prove it. It's likely to leave a scar.
Your dragon did this, Your Grace.
Well, he wouldn't. You must have tried to fight him. What have you done to him? If you've hurt him...
Hurt him?
He attacked us.
Drogon wouldn't strike without reason. You must have scared him. He is not some kind of thoughtless beast. He's only a child.
Oh, a child who can breathe fire on whoever he likes.
The men who are following us, the Lost Legion, they drew their swords and tried to fight him.
And Drogon defended himself. So we somehow deserve to be burnt alive because your little baby was scared. Your tongue is dangerously sharp, sellsword. Why did you come here? You offer me nothing but lies. To what end? You want gold? A title? My undying gratitude?
With your permission, I want to hire a contingent of the Second Sons. I need them to help me fight for my family back in Westeros.
The Second Sons? Has your reason failed you?
Please, if...
I also came here looking for an army. But what I found were the cries of children and people suffering in chains while their masters profited from their misery. My sellswords will help me free the slaves of Meereen. That is their mission. Your need is not greater than theirs. These are people who have suffered for years without end.
What if we left after the liberation, once the slaves are free?
Once the slaves are free, I will sail back to Westeros and reclaim my crown. There is no after.
There must be something I can do to convince you.
As we speak, my men prepare to enter Meereen. What they are about to do is much bigger than you or I. Bigger than one family back in Westeros. So, unless you think you can storm Meereen and free all the slaves yourself...
You have nothing more to offer me.
Croft? You may leave. That's
but
it.
Your Grace.
See them out.
I faced a dragon and lived. Nothing in Meereen can be worse than that.
How bold of you. You forget that is my dragon you boast of defeating.
I said I survived, nothing more.
And Beskar here, she has a history in Meereen. She could help guide us.
What the hell?
Is this true?
Yes. I lived in Meereen for a time. On the eastern side of the city. Fucking bastard.
So you wish to accompany them? You'd help the Second Sons, guide them into Meereen?
I can't, Asha.
This could be our only chance.
Is that what you're saying?
You're really considering this?
They could prove valuable.
I can only speak for myself. I'll go alone.
She's the one who knows the city. She will accompany you, or you won't be going at all.
I believe that's more than fair. You two will join Croft and his men. Get them into the city, help them liberate Meereen, and I will see that you are rewarded. But your uncle stays here. If I find you've lied or put my men in danger...
I understand.
Good. Croft will get you settled in. It's going to be a long night.
Back there. Are we really going into Meereen?
Look, I'm sorry it happened this way.
As long as you get your army, right?
Beskar.
Get your armor patched up in here. Extra bedrolls if you need them. Piss buckets in the corner where it's always fucking been.
Long time since we had a piss bucket.
I spent 2 years trying to get where I am now. Don't fuck this up for me, Asher. Nail! We got two more!
It's not your leg that's the problem, Roderick. You've got to be practical. You want to take Griff down next time? You want to stop lying in the mud and letting people walk all over you?
You're speaking to your lord, Sir Roiland.
He can fight his own battles.
Look at me, Roiland. You can barely hold this damn thing, much less swing it.
So, you're going to give up then? There are other ways to fight, my lord. You can't handle a sword like you used to. So find another advantage. Surprise your opponent. Do something unexpected.
Like what?
I'll show you. Come at me. Bring your opponent down to your level. When I attack you, drop down, avoid my blade, and swing at the back of my knees. Wait for me to attack.
Roderick!
Let's try it again.
Ha! Now that's how you do it.
I think you'll let me. Oh!
My lord! Sorry to interrupt.
Lena?
She insisted on seeing you immediately.
Lady Elena, I hear we're to become sisters.
Talia. Roderick. Can I speak with you? Privately. You remember my little brother?
Quiver! Good gods, you've grown.
You could just call me Arthur now.
I hope you don't mind us coming unannounced. But something's happened. I didn't know what else to do. Maybe this was a bad idea.
You're always welcome here. We're to be married. You'll be calling Iron Wrath home soon.
Yes, well, that's why I came, actually. Lord Whitehill paid my father a visit at Rillwater Crossing. He told my father Griff had subdued you, and...
And that my sister would make a fine reward.
As if I'm some token to be handed around.
You mean...
He demanded I end our betrothal and marry his son, Griff, instead.
What?
Lud threatened my family. Told my father if he refused, we'd be slaughtered along with you.
Father acted the damn coward.
He agreed, Roderick. I am to marry Griff Whitehill. That arrogant, pig-eyed prick!
I still can't believe Father agreed to it.
Do you think I want to marry that disgusting pig? But my father won't listen. I'm not going to be the bone they throw that howling dog. I'm not going to be some prize for him to rip open. We have to get rid of him. I can't think of any other way. My father won't see reason. Lord Whitehill's made up his mind. And so have I.
You'd murder a man to prevent your marriage. I know Griffy's horrible, but to go that far...
You don't know what it's like, Roderick. You get to decide what you want to do and who you want to be. I'm expected to have my life decided for me.
You wouldn't have to do it yourself if you didn't want to. We have a way around that.
You brought your men.
I command Father's elite guard. These men are trained archers, swordsmen, experts in both ranged and close combat. They're yours, if you'll help us take down Griff.
The whole guard?
20 men. My father still thinks they're aboard a ship bound for the Reach. What do you have to lose, Roderick? Griff has been a nightmare for you and your house.
You can't have any reason to keep him around.
Whitehill still have my little brother. If I hurt Griff, there's no telling what they'll do to Ryan.
I understand your worry, Roderick. I don't want Ryan hurt any more than you do. I know this might sound mad, but it's the only way. Get rid of Griff, and you'll be free to use the guard however you like. You can finally take control of your house again. Please, promise me you'll do this. I love you, Roderick. I don't want Griff. I don't want any of this.
I'm sorry. I won't make that promise.
You're a bloody coward!
Arthur, would you give us a moment? I know you have to think of your family, but... I don't have a choice here, Roderick. The thought of him touching me, calling me his own, I won't live like that.
We don't have to murder Griff. I can use those soldiers another way.
How? I've thought about it, and this is the only way to be sure. What else could you do to stop it? I know it's drastic.
I can protect you from Griff. You won't have to marry him if you don't want to.
How can you know that?
I'll make sure of it.
All right. The guard is yours.
Thank you, Helena.
I just hope that when the time comes, you'll do what must be done. I guess part of me still hoped that when this was over, we could play hide-and-seek in the grove again, like we used to. Pretend we're still children. Forget all that's happened these last few years.
I love you, Elaine.
I love you too.
Can't believe it's another coronation already.
Our kings just get younger and younger.
Tommen's not ready. He's too soft.
Maybe that was the imp's plan.
I wonder if Marjorie Tyrell would be there today.
You mean Queen Marjorie? She was married to Joffrey.
For all
I
of 1 hour.
She'll marry his brother too.
Not to
I
mention Cersei and Jaime.
Shh.
The Lannisters have spies everywhere.
What is it, Tom?
Remember that warning you'd heard from Roderick?
About Whitehill's contact. Did you find anything?
Only whispers. But your brother's right. Lord Whitehill. Lord Whitehill is sending a great deal of gold to someone here in King's Landing. He's definitely up to something. Something big.
That's all you found out? I already knew that much.
It's the best I could do. The only people I'm even certain he deals with are those ironwood merchants.
Lord Morgren and Lord Andros.
They'll both be at the feast after Tommen's coronation today. Maybe you can learn something.
I can't go. Marjorie's... she's not exactly happy with me right now. I've been uninvited.
Couldn't Sarah help? Ask her to get you in. She'd do it, right? Don't handmaidens look out for each other?
Oh, I'll figure it out, Tom.
Well, whatever you decide, do it soon.
It's nearly time.
Just be careful, Lady Mira. King's Landing seems to have it in for you.
Leftover honey cake in the kitchens.
Have to guard this one. Locked him up in the old storeroom until morning.
That the one who killed Brit? He's not going anywhere. Come on. He'll be back before anyone notices.
All right. Maybe just a quick bite. He's likely to freeze to death out here anyway.
Just sand. Oh, wood's rotten. This is all bloody useless. Onions and crab apples. At least I won't starve to death. If I ever find a way out of here. That might be useful. Oh, I'm not getting out that way. Don't know what I expected. No one out there. Doing it.
I heard him talking. You're to be executed in the morning.
What about Finn? He told
them. Nobody believes him. Or don't want to. They think he's covering for you. Some are even saying he helped you do it.
I have to get out of here.
That's why I came. I want to help.
You'd be executed too. Why would you want to help me?
I told you my secret. And you said you were my friend. Oh, what kind of friend would I be if I left you to die here? So I'm getting you out of here. I don't want to hear any complaining.
You're a good man. You know that.
Don't go singing my praises just yet. I want you to take me with you. to the North Grove. You know I can't stay here. I'm leaving Castle Black, but I'd rather not go it alone. So if you're going north, I'm coming with you.
Well, I'm not going anywhere unless I can get out of this bloody storeroom first.
I can try and pick the lock, but I'm not sure it will work. Garrett, what are you doing?
Getting out of here.
I can see it. It's coming loose.
I'm gonna try to push it out.
You pull, all right? I hope no one heard that. Hey, can you fit through?
I think. You two idiots, lucky I'm not Frostfinger. Thought you were being sly, eh?
I figured you'd try something like this.
Oh, Finn. Am I glad to see you?
I'm the sword in the darkness. Help me a fellow brother keep his head.
You'll need this.
Now, let's go.
You're not coming with us, Finn.
What are you on about? Frostfinger already thinks I'm helping you. What do you think he's gonna do when he hears you've run off with Potato Fucker over here? I'd rather take my chances with you. And I'm good in a fight. You know that.
Yeah, good at starting them anyway.
You'll need another blade at your side.
Having another ranger along couldn't hurt.
Till he stabs you in the back.
We'll talk later. Move!
There's no turning back now. We're deserters for sure. We're breaking our vows.
I've taken plenty of oaths. Broken plenty too. Words don't mean shit.
There'll be a price on our heads.
I didn't mean for it to come to this. The vows I took here, I meant them. And someday I'll come back to one of them.
They know we're gone now.
Then how fast can you run?
worse than I thought, isn't it?
Roderick! There you are.
Lady Forrester!
What's wrong, Mother?
It's Griff. He was arguing with the Maester and things got out of hand.
I'm coming.
What do you mean to do? This could be our chance.
He's right. We must hurry before things get violent.
I want to try talking to him first, see if we can work this out.
And if that fails, you may have to do more than talk.
That'll be my decision, Al.
The rest of my men are still in the grove. They could be here in minutes.
You'd best go get them, Arthur.
Yes, of course. Let's go.
And Arthur. Listen for my signal. I'll strike my cane when I want you to enter.
We'll be ready.
I'm coming with you.
It's not safe. You should wait for your brother.
I don't care if it isn't safe.
Griff thinks I belong to him. I need to show him I don't.
Together, then.
Obey his new master. And while you're at it, Elena Glenmore, what are you doing with him? You're supposed to be marrying
you.
Me.
I'd rather marry a dead horse.
You watch your bloody tongue, or I'll give you what I'm giving the Maester.
Excuse me?
Let the Maester go, Griff.
Not until he's learned his lesson. He's disobedient, just like you were, Roderick. Before I brought you to heel. So now he's paying the price.
Oh, my hand!
I'm sorry.
Don't believe you.
You're not the Lord here, Griff. And I'm tired of you pretending you are.
You think I'm fucking pretending? You know what I think?
My brother is ready.
I think you need another lesson in humility. Just like your maester here.
You can watch if you like.
I've let you off too fucking easily, Roderick. What the hell is this?
What are your orders?
I'm the only one here who gives the orders. What are you waiting for? Come on, defend your lord!
Take their weapons.
What are you doing? Drop it!
Now.
This is my hall! You have no right to be here!
Now then, about humility.
Get your hands off me!
Maester. Are you all right?
Yes, I think so. My father will go straight to Ruth Bolton. He'll flay you and your sister and your own fucking family!
I did warn you, Griff.
You gonna hurt me? Your friends won't be around forever, Roderick. And when they're gone, I will see that you pay for this! What's it gonna be, Roderick?
We're done here. Clear out. Confine the White Hills to the cellars.
No one gets in or out.
Coward! Bloody coward!
Word cannot reach High Point. You must be sure of it. Not as long as they still hold Ryan. Kill the Ravens. All of them.
I swear I will!
Fuck you and your queen!
That's enough! So long as you're in my camp, you will obey my orders. And getting pissed drunk before a mission.
Okay.
You know what kind of shipwreck does that? One who wants to fucking die out there. Have you lost your damn mind?
I am not some animal in a cage.
What in the seven bloody hells are you talking
about? I will not let you bark orders at me.
I'm glad to see you two are getting along. Warms the heart.
I'm not the one with the problem. It's him.
She can't fight like this, Asher.
You think I'm too drunk to fight? What the fuck
do
you know?
What are you gonna do? Run out there swinging a fucking...
Still think I can't fight?
You fucking bitch!
Oh, there we go.
Hey, come on, Beska. Leave the poor man...
Let go of me before I break your fingers.
Deal with your friend. She'll get us all killed.
You sound scared, Croft.
This is bloody important.
You afraid your mother will spank you?
I will not let you two fuck...
I'll talk to her.
Good. If she can't hold it together, we're leaving without the both of you.
You think your little thumbcock can take Marine all by itself? I'd never work with a bloody show like you
Beska,
anyway!
What the hell is going on?
You gonna lecture me too? Croft doesn't know shit about anything. None of you do.
Will you stop trying to hit me? Whatever your problem is with Croft, just let it go.
You think this is about Croft? You think I give two shits about what Croft has to say? Your fucking uncle's the only reason I'm even here. He told your little dragon queen I would go into Marine with you. You brought me... Come on, Asher. Hit me. Oh, if this was a real fight, you'd be dead. Do you want to help?
I'm not going to do that! Whatever your problem is with Marine, you have to get over it!
Get over it? I was a slave! Here, in this fucking city! I was taken from my home when I was only 3 years old. When I was seven, my master threw me in the fighting pits to die. When my master tired of watching me kill animals for sport, he started sending other children. I butchered every one of them. After a while, I thought the fear was gone. I thought I was used to it. You never get used to something like that.
But you had no choice.
I did. I decided my life was worth saving, but theirs were not. There was this boy. We used to play five stones in the alley when we couldn't sleep. When I saw him next, he was in that pit with me. I saw the fear in his eyes. Same fear I felt my first time. And I realized it hadn't left me. I still wanted to live. I wanted it so badly. My master watched as I did it. Smiling. I could have killed him for that fucking smile.
Here.
Thank you, little brother. I bought my freedom a long time ago, but I have always hated this place. Hated him. Dezor Zoraza. Because of that man. Marine is a city of dead children. Don't worry about me. I won't let you down.
I know you won't.
You shouldn't say that.
Why not?
Mira, I'll meet you inside. What are you doing here?
I have to get in there, Sarah. I know I'm not supposed to attend, but...
Then you know Lady Marjorie doesn't want to see you. What could be so important? If you can't even talk to me... Lady Marjorie would be furious, Mira. I can't. I'm sorry. I want to help you, but I can't risk it. Oh, come on, Mira. Fine. Just stop making that face already. You owe me for this. She's with me. We'll stay out of trouble. I promise. Feels a bit strange to celebrate, doesn't it? Not so long ago, King Joffrey sat on the Iron Throne.
Tommen is our king now.
Long may he reign.
Sarah! I was worried you'd run off with your friend there.
And what if I did?
I'm not sure I could blame you.
This is Lady Mira Forrester. Mira, Lord Garibald Tarwick.
She's quite lovely. Where have you been hiding her?
You're making her blush.
You flatter me. Sarah's lovelier than us all.
I won't argue there. It's quite a feast, isn't it? Just be careful around the wine. Though I hear you don't partake yourself. It's easy to forget. Nothing you do in King's Landing goes unnoticed. Drink too much once and you're forever the drunken fool. Talk to the wrong people and...
Lord Tarwick!
What was that about?
Nothing. That subject isn't fit for your delicate ears anyway.
My ears are not delicate.
Of course they are. Look how tiny they are. Little loads.
Stop it.
What?
I mean it. Someone caught your eye, Mira?
I have to take care of a personal matter.
Oh. Well, don't let us stop you then.
If you'll excuse me.
This reminds me of the tourney at Lannisport. You wouldn't believe them.
You told me this story.
But you would have loved it. We danced all evening, drank wine from our helmets.
That is it! Andras, you're being ridiculous!
Please, if you'll excuse me.
Lady Mira, I'm impressed.
Impressed with what?
That you aren't currently locked in a cell. I trust this means that you took care of that contract. How did you do it, if I may ask? I wasn't expecting to see you again, if I'm being honest. You must have made quick work of it.
All right. You can keep your secrets. I do believe King's Landing is rubbing off on you.
So, what have you been up to?
Enjoying yourself?
Though I suppose if you're talking to me, you must want something. Don't tell me you just enjoy my company.
Well, I'm afraid I have nothing to offer you. My situation has changed since our last meeting. I've been pushed out of the Ironwood business.
Oh.
All thanks to my partner. Bloody imbecile. Andros is now Lud Whitehill's exclusive contact in King's Landing. No matter the fact that I introduced them in the first place. That man would be nothing without me.
Do you know what Lord Andros is planning?
He's acquired a large amount of gold, but I haven't the slightest idea what he intends to buy with it. Whatever it is, he's managed to get a Lannister involved.
A Lannister?
Lyman. He may only be a third cousin, but he's a Lannister all the same.
Rickard! Are you done flirting with that handmaiden? We need your opinion here.
Oh, leave him alone.
Please excuse me.
Lord Tarwick?
Well met, Lady Mira. I hope you're enjoying yourself. Have you had any luck?
Luck? With what?
I saw you talking to Lord Morgan over there. This place is full of eligible men. I assumed you were on the lookout for a husband.
That isn't really what Mira's interested in.
Nonsense. You must have your eye on someone.
Oh, don't press her, Garibald.
I'm only curious. No harm in that. You can tell me.
I was wondering what you could tell me about Lyman Lannister.
Lyman? Really, that story is not appropriate for present company.
That joke's getting a bit tired, don't you think?
I wouldn't want you to think ill of someone you've never met. Don't be angry.
Perhaps later, then.
Perhaps another time.
I should be going.
Stay out of trouble, Mira.
Excuse me. Lyman Lannister?
Shit.
You startled me. As if I don't already have enough to deal with.
Here, let me help.
That's very kind of you, thank you. But I'm fine. I just get clumsy sometimes. I'm afraid you have me at a disadvantage, Lady...
Mira.
Lady Mira. I'm not used to being approached so boldly. But I'm glad you did. I always feel a bit out of place at big gatherings like this. So, what brings you over here? I'm not the best company, I'm afraid. Or were you headed for the wine and I got in your way?
From what I hear, you're in the business of making rather important deals happen.
Well, I don't know about that.
Come on, don't be modest.
I really shouldn't talk about it. Andros came to me in confidence. You understand? He wouldn't be pleased, I'm sure.
I respect that. Trust is so rare in King's Landing.
I'm glad you think so. And just between us...
Lyman! What do you think you're doing?
What? Nothing.
You stay away from him.
Andros! We were just talking.
You were just talking to Myra Forrester.
Forrester? I didn't realize.
My lord?
Let me say this as plainly as I can. Don't ever meddle in my affairs again!
Lady Marjorie. Lady Marjorie.
Lady Myra? That was quite a scene over there. Are you all right?
I'm fine. I can handle Lord Andros.
It's Lyman I was worried about.
What do you mean?
Honestly, that story isn't fit for a maiden's ears. Just be careful around him. All right?
Just tell me, Lord Tarwick. It's important.
I may be willing to tell you. If you'll first tell me something about Sarah. Your help could save me a lot of embarrassment. I'd be very grateful, Lady Myra.
What do you want to know about Sarah?
Sarah Durwell. Interesting name, that. Funny thing is, the last Durwells died off almost 200 years ago. What can you tell me about her family? Something isn't quite right, but I'm not sure. You must understand, I can't court a woman just because I like the way she laughs.
I've met the Durwells when I was at Highgarden.
Oh?
They're a small house these days, but very well regarded.
Ah, right. Well, that's a relief. For a moment, I thought...
And now, Lord Tarwick, it's your turn.
Right. Lyman Lannister. 10 years ago, Lyman was injured at the tourney at Lannisport. He took a bad fall from his horse, needed milk of the poppy for weeks just to keep from screaming.
Oh.
And between us, he's never stopped drinking the stuff. Can't stop, actually. He spent all his money trying to get more. The man can't go a day without it.
So that's why he shakes.
You mustn't repeat that, Lady Myra. I shouldn't even know about it. Besides, Lyman suffered enough embarrassment. And every man's entitled to his secrets.
Then why did you tell me?
Because of... Well, maybe I shouldn't have. I'd hate for Lord Andros to trace this back to me.
You learned that from Andros?
The man's mouth is bigger than the Blackwater. Poor Lyman has no idea. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some arrangements to make. Lady Myra?
Lord Lyman, we really need to talk.
I know what you're up to. I won't discuss my business with Andros, so please, please, just leave me alone. You've landed me in enough trouble. Just leave.
Look at you. You're shaking.
It's an old injury.
But there's more to it than that, isn't there?
What are you saying? Either tell me what you want, or go bother someone else. I don't have to stand here and take this.
Lord Andros has betrayed you. I know everything.
What?
What do you...
The milk of the poppy. You drink it like wine. Ever since your injury at Lannisport.
He wouldn't... Andros wouldn't...
He's not your friend. He's been using you.
I trusted him.
He spilled your secrets. So why not spill his?
Andros is hiring sellswords. Hundreds of them.
What?
He's building an army for Lord Whitehill, big enough to march against Ironwrath. But Andros is doing it in secret. No one knows. Or at least, he doesn't want anyone to know. I told him I'd keep quiet, but...
That army will destroy my family.
That was his hope, I'm sure, but I... You bloody traitor. You promised me. Then you told everyone?
What are you talking about?
You're a liar. I should never have trusted you. She told me everything.
Lady Mira, you've just made a very grave error. Very grave indeed. You realize that, I hope.
Don't be so bloody dramatic, because I'm just getting started.
Sure you know where you're going?
Cotter?
Let's see that map again.
So you're asking now, are you? Surprised you haven't taken it from my pocket already.
How much food we got left? Here we are. Carried.
Oh, there's still plenty left.
Good. It means we won't have to stop for a while. Finn doesn't eat it all first.
You think I can't hear you?
We're on the right track. This way.
Free folk. Oh, thanks. This complicates things. You stay here. I'll try and talk to her. I'm one of them.
Wait, what? He's a fucking wildling, Cotter!
They might kick me around a little, but whatever you do, don't come out, all right? She has to think I'm alone. If she sees you, you'll only make things worse.
No, I'm a friend. I grew up near Ardholm. You know it? I won't hurt you, all right?
You won't.
I'm one of you.
You sure look like a crow to me.
You're dressed like one.
You out here all alone, little pup. Come out or I'll kill your friend. Or I'll make him scream first.
Listen, I don't want to fight. He's not alone.
I knew a little crow wouldn't wander off by himself.
Leave them be, all right? Just take me.
Let him go. That we're just passing through.
We didn't mean any harm.
Right. You and your fuckless men just want to kill us all and take our land. But you didn't mean any harm.
Garrett.
Kill them!
Fighting you! It's over! Just don't do it! Garrett!
Are those the last of our supplies?
We can't stay.